Nelson Mandela won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1993. This was 3 years after his release from prison, in 1990, where he had spent the last 27 years of his life. He was president of South Africa from 1994 to 1999. He was born in South Africa as a member of one of Africa's royal families, on July 8, 1918 and passed away on December 5, 2013. Mandela studied law and practiced as a lawyer in South Africa following the completion of his law articles or legal apprenticeship. He studied law throughout his life, including the LLB program at the University of London, by correspondence when he was in prison. Mandela officially began his rights advocacy for legal rights in 1943, when he joined the Political African National Congress, the ANC. However, the official apartheid laws were not legislated by the South African regime until 1948. It is worthwhile noting two of Mandela's legal issues with the South African government while advocating for rights. The first issue is referred to as the treason trial. Mandela was one of 156 individuals tried beginning in 1956 and was found not guilty of treason by the time the trial ended in 1961. The second legal issue is referred to as the Rivonia trial that was conducted from 1963 to 1964. Mandela was found guilty of matters related to state or national security, and sentenced to serve the rest of his life in prison. However, Mandela was already in prison since 1962 to serve a 5-year sentence, for his conduct that included leaving the country without official permission from the government. Therefore, Mandela remained in prison after the 1964 Rivonia national security-related guilty verdict. Without regard for what appeared to be Mandela's acquiescence of authoritarian rule on the condition of participation, or representation of the people under the specific regime, Mandela is particularly important to the American 1789 constitutional style of rights for two reasons. Firstly, as revealed in his argument during the 1962 trial that led to his 5-year prison sentence, Mandela attempted to demonstrate that there exists a critical legal point at which no branch or officer of the South African government could act as a supreme or balanced lawful factor. Secondly, in his "I am prepared to die" speech during the opening of the Rivonia trial in 1964, Mandela recognized that even the black man in the most difficult ghetto of South Africa, in the 1960s, embodied a legal human dignity threshold. This is Human Rights News by Patricia Younghans, selecting Mandela for Human Rights Advocate Profile.